disease is a limiting monitor of disease or pathogenesis of disease. The signs and lesions that observed in disease deficient methods used for diagnosis, main approaches for treatment and control. And Leprosis is one of the most prevalent diseases of marine, brackish, and freshwater fishes. The disease called red boil disease, red disease of eels, saltwater pharyngosis, and red pest. Several Vibrio species infect fishes. Some of them cause occupational hazards and of public health importance, as Vibrio aeruginoticus, Vibrio damascena, and Vibrio mucus. It's caused wound infection and septicemia in workers handled infected fish. While Vibrio parahepatitis, Vibrio cholerae vero 1, Vibrio cholerae non vero 1, Vibrio vulnificans, causing food poisoning, and cholera-like symptoms was rice, water, diarrhea for consumers. It also two fish species cause serious disease in cultured fishes, the Vibrio anguillara and the Vibrio salmonicida. Leprosis, or called listinolosis. Leprosis or listinolosis is an endotic septicemic disease of all species of fishes. Characterized clinically by mortality, large appearance of the skin, dolphins, all sorts of the skin on the skin. It causes the primary cause of the secondary cause of predisposing connection. Primary cause lead Vibrio anguillara or Listeriella anguillara. The gram negative straight root, curved root. مطين Listeriella Vibrio anguillara based on recent classification and the phylogenetic data of it. Transferred the Vibrio anguillara to a new genus, Listeriella, but the name Vibrio is still widely used all over the world. ومن هذا الفيبروزيس بقت اسمها Listeriellosis. الفيبرو جرام نيجاتيف بكتيريا مطين grow rapidly على البرين هارت انفيوجن وعلى تريبتك صويا اجار containing 1.5% sodium chloride. Also, we can use selective differential method to differentiate between the fish Vibrio species isolated from different fishes. A TCBS, oxide sulfate citrate, bile salt, sucrose, agar, can be used, and the organism grow either green or yellow according to species. The colonies appear to green or yellow according to species. TCBS contain sucrose. The Vibrio species ferment sucrose appears as yellow colonies. Sensitive to vibrostatic agents, the novobiocin. Sodium chloride tolerance varied according to species, up to 10%. We can use biochemical tests. Different biochemical tests can be used for identifications of the organisms. Based on biochemical reaction, Vibrio anguillara or Listeriella anguillara has 6 biotype. Based on osmotic antigen, has 10 serotype. All the Listeriella anguillara is used from different fish species are antigenically related. So we can use the monovalent or polyvalent and sera for serological identifications. And also can be set up due to the low number of strains, we can make vaccination. Make vaccine and they used. And predisposing factor. As we previously discussed, in different fish and different diseases in fish, fish rearing under culture condition exposed to stress factors as overcrowding, high ammonia, high water pH and ammonia, followed by nitrites, the organic pollutions, low dissolved oxygen concentration, heavy metals of copper and iron triggers infections, and also rise the temperature of the water. And source of infection, the organisms are found as opportunistic organisms found in the aquatic environment. Fish can be infected by skin or mouth, but the organism affected by the attack of stomach and eel and trout. So the infection of these fish via ingestion is a little bit slow. Pathogenesis, the microorganism secretes several virulence factors that has been identified as livable saccharides, which as we previously discussed, it's an endotoxin, proteases, which can be used for invasiveness, and hemagglutinin, agglutinate lean RBCs, and also cellular force and protein secreted by the organisms used for escaping of iron from the body tissue, body fluid, extracellular toxins that affect the intestinal tract, vascular and hemorrhagic effect, cytotoxic effect, and lethal effect. Microorganisms enter via skins or skin abraded or via mouth or contaminated water, reach to the blood, get multiply and circulate and reach to the different tissues and organs of the body. With an acute sense of disease, the forms of disease differ according to the virulence of the invasive organism, number of the invasive organism, environmental factor or stress factor, and also the immune status of the fish. In acute form, fish show high mortality rate without obovia, without any clinical signs. The subacute, the organism in subacute form, the signs appear external hemorrhagic appearance, the skin elevations, skin ulcers, superficial ulcer with red edges, the corneal opacity. The chronic form, the diffuse white spots, swelling surrounded with red edges, ulcers with congested periphery, hemorrhagic spots on orbital cavity, turbid eye, or the blindness. Lesions, internal lesions, في الأكوت فور, internal lesions, internal hemorrhages and hyperemia في internal organs. في السابأكوت, الجلد hyperemic في hemorrhagic appearance, liver swell, liver والكدني والسبلين, sometimes تبقى swollen, congested and had gray patches. الانس is redden and swollen while leakage of yellow viscous material. The eye showed opacity of the eye lens. في الكورونيك فور, في الكورونيك فور turbid eye ulcerated evolution of the orbital content. In skin ulcer, في red lesions or red bulls found في muscles, especially في salmon fish. Large pale liver with BTK, في splenomegaly or large spleen, distended في intestine filled with yellow transparent fluid, especially في severe cases of vibriosis in fish. الدياجنوزز في فيلد دياجنوزز وفي لاب دياجنوزز. فيلد دياجنوزز mostly focuses on case history, signs and lesions as we previously discussed. في اللابراتوري دياجنوزز direct isolation of the organisms on the media containing sodium chloride 1.5% sodium chloride using the gram staining, motility test, sensitivity to hypersthetic agents, biochemical identification, phenotypic test, or we can be used the ABI-20E, this as a rapid test for identification of organisms. We can use advanced techniques, the PCRs, we electrophoresis, and others. diagnostic tests. Serological identifications using paper angularans or antigen serotype were recorded, and also as we see, if you close the antigen relationship, and so we can use serological diagnosis by monovalent and polyvalent hyperimmune serum. For complete identification, in indirect diagnosis, we can use the blood, the serum, detect the antibody. We use a serum for detecting antibody. We can use the blood disease, our RBC count, and show the other hematological changes. You can be used for a diagnosis. In indirect diagnosis, mostly we focus on the effect of the organism on the function of the internal organs, as we can use the kidney function test and a liver function test for diagnosis of the disease. To complete diagnosis of the microorganisms, experimental infection can be done, and after that, studies histopathological reactions that appear within situ. Prevention and control. Preventive measures should be used to avoid all the predisposing factors, as skin fluke eradications and gill fluke eradications, and both parasites can cause skin erosions and use other portal of entry for the organisms. Provide food of good quality, avoid overcrowding, risk of ammonia nitrite, avoid use of water polluted with organic matter and inorganic matter as metal on the cover, avoid use of previously infected fish as a source of fish for feeding of fish. The fish holding facilities shouldn't be coated with copper or copper containing antifouling compound, because it's the copper and iron that triggers the infection of the disease. We can use vaccination to prevent of disease, and also we can use immunostimulant as a probiotic to enhance the immune status of the fish. The treatment in chemotherapeutic agents are used as food additive. The oxytetracycline, dexed as a derivative, nitrofurans, and sulfonamide. The tetracycline and quinolone are still the first drug of choice for histonellosis. But withdrawal time for sulfa drug is ranged from 21 to 42 days, according to the marketable products. For treatment, as we discussed before, we must firstly make the sensitivity test against different type of antibiotic and sulfa and antimicrobial agent to be used. The other disease affecting the fish, by Vibrio species called water vibriosis or Hetra disease, so mostly salmonid fish, so characterized by anemia, hemorrhage على البيلي and eye cataract splenomegaly, caused by Vibrio salmonicida. ننتقل لمرض آخر، الفلافوباكتيريوزيس. الفلافوباكتيريوزيس من الأمراض الموجودة في الأسماك، والفلافوباكتيريوزيس هناخد منها الكولمناريس ديزيز والبكتيريال جيل ديزيز. اليولو بيجمنتد بكتيريا، اليولو بيجمنتد بكتيريا الكولمناريس ديزيز ديفينيشن. المرض عبارة عن acute and chronic disease of cultured fish characterized by signs of hypoxia, white patches of subtle back lesions على البادي and mouse fungus in severe cases. ال cause of columnaris في flavobacterium columnari في ال fresh water و still في ال marine water fishes. ال causes plexibacter meritmus. ال columnaris أو flavobacterium gram negative root flexus filaments motile by gliding movement, not by flagella. Sensitive to sodium chloride, to 2% grow على specific media or dial media. والorganisms بتبقى differ في الorganism grow على media differ. In the quality is different than other bacteria, it's raised result of an evidence geologic orange in color. Organism is ubiquitous organisms found in aquatic environment and not all fish are susceptible. كان الفيش كان infected via mouth or gills or skins. الميكروأورجانيزم produce several virulence factors that is responsible for setting up of the disease. The organism has capsule outliers, show bactericidal activity, and so it has a bactericidal active effect on the other bacteria that grow on the body surface. Proteases have a direct tissue damage and the invasiveness of the organisms, a lipoblast separates into toxins. In pathogenesis, the microorganism enter via gills or skin or mouth, reach to the blood and then circulate and get localized in skins and gills. Fill skin will get fill gills, cause local inflammation, so damage with ulcerations, maybe extended ulceration all over the body, and the disease is due to respiratory failure. الجلس الميكروأورجانيزم لوكالات في الجل في الجل فيلامنتس يعني جل انفلاميشنز جنريشن اوف جلوكوزس اند سلابين اند ابير ساينس اوف هايبوكسيا ديو تو ريدكشنز اوف ذا ريسبيراتوري كاباسيتي. الساينس اوف هايبوكسيا انكلودينج سيرفاسينج اكيوميليت ات ذا ووتر انلت غاسبينج رب اوبركولار موفمنت. Science and the regions of infection is the columnaries of infections is ectoinfection. The science and the region restricted to the skins and the gills. Morbidity and for management bond reached to 100%. Mortality reached 70% for young listeris fish. Science of hypoxia is hang near the surface, rapid breathing, gasping, accumulate at water inlet, fin rots, small gray patches, spongiform saddle back lesions, cotton wool like in mouse and mouse fungus. Cotton wool work mostly affect with fibroleukinasis. But here the cotton wool like on the mouse fungus caused by columnaris diseases. Cotton wool coating على body, cotton wool disease في المولي, we feel is a sloughed off and the complete losses of pectoral fin, we fish hanged and the body surrounded by a ring, looks like the cotton wool, and mouse fungus we can hear, we can differentiate it between the saprolegnia with mount preparation. Bacterial gill disease cause flavobacterial gill disease. It causes flavobacterium bronchophyllium. Bacterial gill disease is closely related to the environmental gill disease. Both causing sharp reduction in respiratory capacity. Both causing gill rot, bacterial gill rot and environmental gill rot. In bacterial gill disease, the lesions appeared as degeneration necrosis with sloughing of the gills. Reduction on respiratory capacity. في البكتيريا في environmental gill disease it is caused by elevation of ammonia that make continuous irritation of gill inducing fusion of lamellae or filament result hypertrophy and hyperplasia of the gill filaments and so reduce of the respiratory capacity. Both diseases the science appears science of hypoxia as I discussed before. If we are looking here, we find this at the hyperplasia, hypertrophy, and hyperplasia of the gill filament making it elevated, appear as a semi-open opercula, due to mass of the gill filaments which protruded out of the branchial cavity. Diagnosis of Flavobacteria, columnaris disease and bacterial gill disease, in case history, non-science and lesion, the lab diagnosis, isolation of organisms and oral media, gram staining, motility by gliding movement, biochemical identification with set of biochemical characteristics, molecular identification as PCR, serological identification and also experimental and histological studies to complete diagnosis of the treatment the disease is ectoinfection, and so systemic antibiotic and the local treatment with disinfectant is recommended. You can use potassium permanganate 4 mg for 3 successive days, or indefinite pulse for 2 mg per liter. Copper sulfate for 14 microgram for 20 minutes, or sodium chloride 5% for 1 minute as pus. You can use oxytetracycline, antibiotics, and oxytetracycline 55 mg كل كيلوغرام for 10 successive days. الفيوران 1.5 مليغرام لكل 1 hour لمدة 3 days. Water temperature below 12 to 13, no disease progress. So with the reduction of the water temperature, the disease progress can be stopped. Physical treatment, which was called as a physical treatment. Also, we can avoid water stress, avoid water hardness and stress of pH and ammonia and other stress factors. So can be used for vaccinations, and you can use immunostimulant to enhance the resistance, to enhance the resistance, to enhance the immune system of the fish and the resistance against different diseases. A reference can be used in some textbook at spotted and look for information using ekb.eg بنك المعرفة المصري والمنصة التعليمية الجيدة الممتازة التي ممكن أن نستخدمها لنستفيد منها. شكرا جزيلا.